So, in the last lecture, we studied about data collection in Python, and we studied about sets, all the things related to set theory. Now, in this particular chapter, we are going to discuss about dictionary or dictionaries. Dictionaries are same as sets. So, the method of declaring a dictionary is same. Let's say person is equal to and person is equal to. So, in sets also we use curly brackets. In list we use square bracket. And in tuple, we use round bracket. So list was ordered, tuple was ordered, but set was unordered. List can have same element any number of times. Tuple can have same element any number of times. But sets cannot have same element any number of times. List can be changed, set can be changed, but tuple cannot be changed. So there is difference between every data collection. Now person. Let's say if we write our, if we have a variable where we want to write two or three properties, but they are associated with them. They also have some values associated with them. Right? So it is like an associative array. So if we write person name, Rohit. Team India, right? Position one or opener. So we have created a variable called person, right? And this variable has three values, but all the values are broken into key and value pairs. So every value in this particular collection is broken into two parts. One part is the key, this is the key, and this is its associated value, right? So, in this way, we can create a person, some database. We can create some database. This is some database like information, where the keys are columns, right? These are like columns. Name, field, position, these are columns. These are some attributes that are defining this variable. And every column has a value, right? So now if we will try to get the data type of this value, this variable type person, so what we will get is a dictionary, right? Last question, right? Next is, if we'll try to get the next thing is how to access values in dictionary, right? So person is the variable. Now you have to use square brackets. We have been using square bracket for getting values at any particular index. like in list 0, 1, 2, 3 are the position of values, and we use square bracket to get that position. So similarly here, because there is no position here, there are keys there. So in square brackets, we have to write the name of that key. Suppose we want to get the team of this particular person. What is the team of this particular person? So in the team, if we print, we will get India. If we want to print the
name
of this person. So what we are doing is every variable when declared as a dictionary, it will have 3, 4, 5, any number of values. All the values will be broken into two parts. First part will be the attribute or the key, and second part will be the value. If the value is of data type integer, like you can say, if the value is of data type integer, so we are not going to use double quotes. If the value is of data type string or any other, so we are going to use double quotes. So with all the other things related to data types, variables remain the same. Just there is only one difference. The difference is here the index or position is actually replaced by the key value. Right? This is key, this is value, this is key 2. So any dictionary is represented as key colon value, comma key 1 colon value 1, comma key 2 colon value 2, and so on, right? So this is kind of a formula for writing any dictionary. So next property with dictionary is it is unordered, right? It is changeable. So it is unordered, changeable, and indexed. So dictionary is unordered, changeable, and indexed. Can you tell what is set? If dictionary is unordered, changeable, and indexed, what is set?
Set is unordered.
Mutable. So both changeable.
Yeah. Mutable and changeable is
the
same thing.
Immutable is unchangeable. Mutable and immutable and unindexed, right? What is list?
List is
sequence.
List is
ordered.
Index
का मीनिंग है कि हम एलिमेंट्स को उनके पोजीशन के हिसाब से
एडजस्ट कर सकते हैं,
हम उन्हें गेट कर सकते हैं. We can get the elements on the basis of their index. So ordered means they have some order, means 0, 1, 2, 3. But index means they have some, the order in which they are. They are also indexed and they have some position, and we can get the element on the basis of position. So what is tuple?
Tuple
What is tuple? Tuple is also ordered,
unchangeable.
And also indexed. So you can see that there are three properties, but all the three properties are different, which you will not find any similarity between. Something will be different, right? Now, if the position of Rohit Sharma is supposed to change, now we want him to bat at number 2, right? So, in that case, we don't have to completely change the value of dictionary. We don't have to edit all the elements of dictionary. We can simply choose person. We can write the index, right, and make it 2. Person position will go to 2. Now, if you will print person, this is printing person, so you will get name Rohit Sharma, team India, position 2. Right? So, this is how we can create or we can change the value of any value. Change the value of any particular key. We are not changing the key. So we are changing the value from 1 to 2, which proves that dictionary is changeable and indexed. Now, if we want to get the value of any particular index, there is one other method, and that is person dot get. Now you will see there are all the methods have popped up, right?
Yes, sir.
Clear, copy, form, get, items, update, values. So if person is a dictionary and we are using the idle IDE, so simply write percent dot, right, and it will give you all the methods that are associated with or that can be used with dictionaries. Simply writing percent dot. Now percent get, what can get do? Simply write team, right? So we will get some answer as India. So we can either use the square bracket index method, or we can also use get. This is same thing. So person team, person square bracket team, and person dot get team are one and the same thing, right? Now person dot, it will give us some, let's write items. So it is saying built-in method item of dictionary object like this. Now next topic is how to get all key names in dictionary. So our topic is how we can get all key names in a dictionary. So for that we have to use the loop. For loop can be used to get the all key names of dictionary. So what are key names? Key names are identifiers, right? Since they have some values associated with it. So simply write for x in person. This will run the loop. Simply print x. Right? For x in person, print x. So this will give us all the key names of any dictionary, all the key names for x insertion, print x. Similarly, how to get all the values in dictionary or of dictionary. Now, next thing is how to get all the values of dictionary, right? So, x is what? X is name, right? Means x is the key here. So, if we are using for loop for x in person, so what is happening? X is becoming the key. So, if we use this particular method, see closely. If we use this particular method, print persons dot get team. So, if we write person dot get x, so what will the loop do? First, it will put name in place of x. It will give us the first value. Then it will put team in the place of x. It will give the name of team. And at the third part, it will put position, right? So by doing this, we will get all the values of x of the dictionary. Right, person dot get x. And so when the loop runs, when for the first time it will place name here and we will get name. For the second time it will put team here and we'll get team. For the third time it will put position here and we'll get position. जब भी loop चलेगा, loop चलते समय क्या होता है? Loop उतने number, और loop उतने number of times चलता है जो उसकी लिमिट होती है. तो यहाँ पे उसकी लिमिट क्या है? तीन. क्योंकि हमारे पास जो यहाँ पे वेरिएबल है, जो यहाँ पर्सन नाम का वेरिएबल है, उसमें देयर आर ओनली थ्री कीज. इफ वी हैव मोर देन थ्री कीज, सपोज वी हैव 55 कीज एसोसिएटेड विद द पर्सन, सो व्हाट विल हैपन इन दैट केस? इन दैट केस We have to write something else here. Right? We have to write, we don't have to write something here, we just have to write person for x in person get x. So it will get all the values, right? To get all the keys, you have to write print x only. There is another way of doing this, and that is for x in person print person and the position or the key of person x. This will also give the same result, because either we use person dot get x or we use person x. So you have to remember these things. You have to remember all these things, because these all are very important for data analytics purpose. You see, most of the times the relational values will be written in dictionaries. But dictionary is a very important thing. Dictionary is like a database. You can see, we have, suppose we want to create all the players, so we can write 10 dictionaries there, right? Or we can create one dictionary with 10 values in them. So they have to be very specific, right? Now there is one more thing. Suppose we are again creating a instead of creating a person, this time we are creating a dictionary as player. This is single player, right?
Single
player. We are creating a single player and we are using all its attributes. So the name, we are using name. So player name. Remember, always use double quotes or single quotes because name is a string. So these are also strings.
In case of integer,
we don't use single order.
Not a single order.
Suppose you have to simply write name 1.
1 is key.
Right? So you don't have to use single or double. So this is name. And you are writing same thing for Rohit Sharma. Right? Now, or let's say name Kedar Jadhav. Now skills, we are writing skills, so skills colon. And we are using a list because he has two skills. He can do batting as well as bowling. Right? Next thing is position. So, in place of position, what we are going to write is, so we have to write positions like this. Position, let's say he plays at number 5, right? So what is the difference between this dictionary and the dictionary we declared for Rohit Sharma? In this dictionary, all the values were single values, right? Team India, position 1, name Rohit Sharma, all the values were single. But in this particular case, the values are also multiple. Right? Means his skills are batting and bowling. In case of Rohit Sharma, it's only batting. So that's why we are writing skills. So if you will do this, players and skills, so what will you get? Player skills. What will you get? You will get batting, bowling. So now this is a list, right? This is a list and you are getting both the skills. Now, because it's a list, then we can use position. So we can use position 0 or 1, right? So we are using 0 and this will give us only value. So we are using two square brackets. First square bracket is the name of skill. First square bracket is the name of key. And second square bracket is the position of that particular skill which we want to get. Right? So, the values that are represented in a dictionary can be any data type. They can be string, they can be integers, they can be floats, they can be a list, they can be a tuple, they can be a set, or they can be a dictionary also. Right? So you have to remember. And now you can use the square bracket to get it up to any level. Right? Suppose skills was also a dictionary. So in that case, you could have used the key of skills. Let's make it more complicated, but for the sake of analysis. So we are using players, name, everything. Now skills is actually a dictionary, right? Now skills is also a dictionary, and we are giving this player numbers out of 100. So let's say in batting he gets 70 numbers out of 100. In bowling he gets, let's say, 65, because he can do both. And in fielding, so fielding will be a key, and in fielding we are giving him, let's say, again 74 out of 100, right? So what is happening here? If we will print player, we will simply get this, right? So player's name is Kedar. His skills are batting, bowling and fielding, and the skills key has a value, and that value is also a dictionary, right? So skills value is also a dictionary. So how we can deal with something like this? Suppose now we want to print what are the bowling skills of Kedar, right? So how we can do that? First thing is select player, square bracket, now select the skills, and once skills are selected, select the bowling, right? Now we'll get
65.
Yeah. Because bowling is at level 2. If now there's interesting fact that bowling can also be a skill. Bowling can also be a dictionary. Suppose we can break bowling into PM values also. So let's make it more complicated. Now we are getting 65. So
if we use double quote,
you have to use single quotes.
Function here.
If you are writing strings, or if you want to represent a data as a string, then you can use either single or double. In case of dictionaries, we don't have to do that. Now we are making it more complicated, right? This is the part of our practice. Now let's say bowling is a dictionary. Suppose bowling is also a dictionary. So bowling colon round this curly brackets, and we are breaking bowling into, let's say, two parts. Let's say spin. So first key for bowling is spin. So if you are writing about Kedar, let's say we are giving him a number of, for spin he gets 80. Right, comma, and for fast, suppose he can bowl fast but not very well, so we are giving him 20. Right, so for spin he gets 80 numbers, and for fast one, because he cannot bowl pass balls. So at least we haven't seen him ball passed. Now this is also a valid dictionary. So if we want to get the spin balling value of this particular player Kedar, then what are the methods? So again, same thing, player
balling.
Now we just have to one more square bracket
and spin.
If we want to get the value of pass, if we want to get all the values,
now this is another important thing.
So for x in, so we can select this for x in player skills balling. Print player skills balling dot get x. Same thing for x in balling print. Now see this print, first print this player skills balling. So first print the keys, right? This will print the keys and this will print the player skills balling x. So this will print the keys, this will print the value. So spin 80, pass 28. Or if we specifically want to get a spin, we can write a skills balling and spin. So this is a very basic overview of what dictionaries can do, right? Dictionaries, as any other collection, a collection of data. But the main thing with dictionary is a collection with curly brackets, and they have keys and values associated with them, right? We can change the value of dictionaries. We can use loops in dictionaries. Now, if we want to loop through both keys and values at the same time, earlier we were looping through dictionaries using only either key or value. So for x comma y in player, yeah, for simplicity we are using person, which was Rohit Sharma. So for x comma y in person, so person dot item. So for x comma y in person dot items, print x comma y. So now you will get your dictionary printed. For x comma y means we want to put the loop inside all the items of person dictionary, print x comma y, right? So this method will give you the key and value pair, right? In the first line, it will print the first key and first value, in second key and second value, and so on. If we do the same thing with player, which is Kedar. So player dot items, print x comma y. So name Kedar Jadhav, skills batting 70, bowling spin 80, fast 20, fielding 74.
Okay.
So this is the first part of dictionary. We will cover dictionary in another part also. Some small details associated with dictionaries are remaining. So remember, whenever you are revising dictionary or whenever you are studying dictionary using this video, practice also. Is write the code yourself and try to write more complex or more level of dictionaries. Try to add more level of dictionaries in your data and try to get their values and try to look through them so that you have a better understanding of this particular topic. Because it is very much useful for data analytics purpose. When we have to prepare data for data visualization, dictionary is very important. In the next, in later parts of our course, we will study JSON, JavaScript Object Notation. And dictionary and JSON are very much similar. Right, but the way in which data is represented in JSON is very similar to dictionary. So, thanks for watching this video. If you have any doubts, feel free to contact us.